Hey guys, so maybe you just got a drone for Christmas or holidays, or maybe you're not watching this during the holidays, but you just got a drone and you're wondering, now what? So to help explain that, I actually have right here the first real drone I ever owned. This is the Phantom 2, and it's got a third party, I guess it was third party at the time, I don't know, but it's got an add-on gimbal. Definitely got a third-party transmitter here. So you just got a drone and you're wondering, now what do? You unbox it, you see all the stuff. Do you read the manual? Do you need to register something? And I just want to explain all that. So one of the first things you should definitely do is check the local laws, check the national laws, whatever it is. Just check those laws out and make sure you're following them. In the US, you didn't have to register drones. Then they came up with a registration process, then they got rid of it, then they added it. Whatever I say in this video is going to be wrong, so check and see if there's a registration process. I recommend whatever drone you have, even if it's a new drone and you've been using various other drones for a while, use it in beginner mode or whatever that mode is where it comes out of the box and it doesn't do very much. Maybe it flies slower, doesn't go as far. I'll just use this as a prop because my Phantom 4 is in a bag, but my Phantom 4 Pro that has 360 degrees sensing, and you know, I'd been flying this thing for a couple years, but even then when I opened it up, I flew it in beginner mode. I did it for about 5 minutes, probably more like 30 seconds, but I'll say 5 minutes so I seem responsible. I just wanted to get a feel for how the drone sort of operates before I just start doing stuff with it. So make sure you do that. Just don't go in sport mode or whatever at the beginning. Make sure you know all the controls. So the next thing you're probably going to want to do is read a manual, or since you're not going to do that, look online and just watch like a getting started video. I'm sure someone has it. I mean, with these old drones, like, you just take this up and fly. But now with these modern drones, I mean, even the GoPro Karma, that's just for flying your GoPro around. And this has all sorts of settings on it that you want to be aware of before it goes up in the air. So watch a video or read whatever your medium is. There's all sorts of information out there. I just recommend checking out. So a couple of other things I highly recommend. Number one, you're probably going to want a second battery for two reasons. Number one, because they only get a very small amount of flight time, 20 to 30 minutes usually. And number two, I had this issue with this drone because it's so old. When the battery just stopped working and I wanted to fly it, I didn't know. So I actually couldn't use my drone. Now if I had a second battery, I could put it in, but that's the thing. Sometimes batteries go bad and you just don't want to be grounded. But the next thing I actually want to cover is related to this. My gimbal here is actually bent and it doesn't really work very well. And the reason is because I didn't have a bag for this thing, so I highly recommend whichever drone you get. If you didn't get a bag for it or with it, just buy one. It's certainly worth it. Every drone now has gimbals. I mean, even this, how does the gimbal get damaged because it's got legs protecting it? But, you know, it's just over time, it gets knocked around or something. These are very precise pieces of equipment. They're pretty delicate, so just buy a bag for it. You can get a cheap one. I know DJI sells like $400 drone bags. You don't need that. Just get something that will protect this. So just to recap, number one, make sure you check your local, state, federal regulations so that you know what they are before you fly. Number two, make sure that you've looked at some online video or something, or you've read the manual, just so you don't have to read it fully, but just have some sort of understanding of what's going to happen when the drone turns on, when it takes off, when you go to land it, stuff like that. Number three, consider getting a second battery if you don't already have one, not only because flight time isn't great, but if your battery ever dies on you for some reason, you don't want to be on vacation and suddenly not be able to fly your drone. And the last one is make sure that you buy some sort of bag or some sort of protection thing for your drone. So I hope this video helps. I hope you learned something. And if you have some comments of your own, some tips of your own that you think can help other people, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.